Welcome to this week's Yep Yeah Yes with Tamika and Marissa. This week we're going to talk about shadiness, and when you find out somebody's shady, we ain't surprised. So Tamika, how was your week?
Not bad, not bad. I actually went to Atlantic City for the weekend with my cousin.
You win that million?
No, I didn't win the million, because if I did, we wouldn't be doing this podcast right now.
Yes, so we would.
We might be doing it next week, because I'd be on vacation.
You?
But I had a good time. It's nice to get away and, you know, relax and gamble, eat some good buffet and that kind of thing. So.
How's your cough?
I still have a bit of a cough, but, you know, it is what it is. Allergies, you know?
Pollen-mageddon.
Yep. How about you?
My week was good. I feel real busy, though. I don't know why. I feel real busy, torn apart, and my allergies are kicking my behind.
Are you taking anything?
I broke down, and I took this Claritin stuff, but I feel like it didn't work.
You need to take Zyrtec once a day, or Flonase, or both of them.
Together? Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Flonase is right up the nostril. Oh. I don't understand, like, how people do cocaine.
Like,
foreign subject in your nostrils.
And they sniff it all the way up, yeah. Right? You don't feel it in the back, right? Like, when you're doing, like, a nasal spray, you feel that all the way, like, in your brain.
You just feel it. Like, you know, I don't want to sniff too
all
hard.
Back there.
Goes into your throat and... Anyway. So, yeah. Try it.
I will. Thanks. So, I want to talk about shadiness. So, this week it came out about Mario Batali.
Great.
And, but here's
the part two of Mario.
Part two. But here's the thing, though. So, you and I had went to a taping of The Chew a while back.
Mm-hmm.
And we were both...
First, explain what came out.
Wait. Oh,
not
sorry,
everybody
Mario
knows.
Batali. Okay, yeah. Sexual misconduct, sexual assault, and, so, it's sexual misconduct and sexual assault. And how was the wording? Creating an environment that is not safe or sexually safe for other women. So it's claimed that one of his restaurants downtown Manhattan, he has a, what they're quoting, a sex room, and he would drug women and assault them and leave them there.
I just have to say, like, the restaurant called the Spotted Pig is not actually his restaurant. He just invested
in it. He's one of the investors. Correct, correct.
Along with, like, Jay-Z and Robert De Niro. Like, there's a million people that are...
Right.
Basically have a table whenever they want.
Yeah.
That's what it amounts to.
Yeah, exactly. So, you and I had went to a taping of The Chew eons ago,
mm-hmm.
where he was formerly a host. A collection of the hosts. And we were both like, ew. Not gracious. Came out just as, like, the camera was like, 5, 4, 3, 2, and would walk out, not talk to anyone. He wouldn't even talk to the other host. And
right.
What's homegirl's name that's on The Chew?
I can't remember her name.
I forget her name all the time, but he treats her like... I felt like the way he spoke to her was very demeaning and disgusting. Like,
right.
I remember one time they were making, like, this Italian dish. He was like, oh, you've never been to Italy? Not everybody's been to Italy, fucking Batali.
Mm-hmm.
With Gwyneth Paltrow, walking around with Gwyneth Paltrow, fucking using goop, but whatever. I digress. Gwyneth Paltrow's another one that really gets my gullet. But anyway... So, when that came out about him, it was one of those, like, oh, yeah, makes sense.
Not surprised.
I'm not surprised at all.
And it's like, not that we knew that it was going to go to this extreme.
Yeah.
But the thing that doesn't surprise me is that he's an asshole.
Yeah.
He's entitled.
Yeah.
He thinks he can do whatever he wants to do, however he wants. You know what I mean?
With his yellow Crocs. Orange Crocs.
Orange Crocs. And I have enough forever, you know. Just his whole demeanor. Like you said, when we were at The Chew, it was very, like... You know, off-putting. Like, you know, you would think that you'd be a little bit gracious. Like, the other hosts came up and they, you know...
They were very, like, welcoming, talked
right.
to other people.
Right. He just was not. He was off-putted.
That show has gotten a lot better without him on it.
Full disclosure, I've never even watched the show.
Oh,
not
really?
Even episode we was on.
Oh, yeah.
I just not, you know...
You know what? I really like when holidays come about and, like, they have some recipes and they always play clips at Target.
Mm-hmm.
So I see it there a lot, too.
The thing, speaking of, like, these shows, like, is it wrong to... Like you were saying, like, we're not surprised about, you know, the allegations that are coming out with him.
No.
Are there other people... Who you have this feeling about, but
yes.
It hasn't come out yet.
Oh, that hasn't come out yet?
But things that, like, what I'm getting at is, when I think about him, I think about Rachel Ray.
Mm-hmm.
like, she's supposed to be this, like,
she's not
a jerk, and
she is a jerk.
So when that story came out that she was talking about Oprah in the restaurant, like, I believe it.
I completely believe
it. Like, everything to me that she, even
and we went to her taping too, and she was
she was just not cool. She's just
bizarre.
Yeah, I just, there's just certain people where when certain stories break, you just, you say to yourself, okay,
makes sense.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So has anyone with sexual allegations like that, like of misconduct? There's a comedian that I wasn't really, I'm not very familiar with, but had allegations come out against him, that Louis C.K.
Okay.
And I'm not, I don't know much about his stand-up, and I don't know much about him, but I wasn't like, no. I mean, he has, according to, this is verbatim from an acquaintance of mine, he has a 45-minute set about beating off. Of course he's going to say something off-putting to a woman. And you're like, oh.
So, Makes sense. People tell you, when people tell you who they are, believe them.
Oh my gosh, that is your line.
It's not my line. I stole it.
Oh.
I heard it first from Oprah.
But
she probably got it from Maya Angelou, who probably got it from her slave grandmother.
Oh,
you know what I mean? Like,
yes. I know why the cage bird sings.
You know, your daughter's going to be like, this too shall pass, like my TT used to say. Meanwhile.
I'm the one who said it! But I'm not surprised. And then I think about the Facebook Live assault, physical assault, not sexual assault, with Ronnie from the Jersey Shore with his baby's mother. It's another one of those things, like, I'm not surprised that he did
that. The thing about it, too, with that, have you watched the show at all?
Yeah.
So, it happened the week that the episode aired that he, you know, with the French fries.
Mm-hmm.
And if anybody watches the show, they know what I'm talking about. But the thing about it is, like, in that episode or the episode after, when, around that time, he was like, he's not going to tell her until he gets home because he didn't want to embarrass her on TV.
But he did embarrass her.
And I'm like, did you tell her at all? Because that reaction to me is, that tells me that that's the first time she saw it.
She saw it.
You didn't even tell her when you got home.
But you think about it. Somebody who's consistently claiming that they'd rather pay child support than alimony.
Right.
For you to even say something like that.
That's disgusting.
Like, but first of all, I take umbrage at the fact that you think that somebody wants to husband you up. Like, you really think you're husband material? Get out of here, bro.
So whack. And the whole season, he only keeps talking about is Sam.
Oh.
It's like, you know, she's sitting back like, mm-hmm,
laughing her anus off.
Right.
But she's probably going to show up on the show because, you know, I'm sure her check will be
surprised.
Nice.
I wouldn't be surprised. The last episode.
Yeah,
you know,
she's going to show up at some point. And then, you know, of all the people that we do talk about, like, we talk about, we're lucky because in New York, there's a lot of things that tape here. So we have gone to the Chew. And with this Mario Batali thing, I'm not surprised. We've been to a taping of Rachel Ray. Ugh. I still go, but it's like, ugh.
I'm not going, though. I told you the last time.
Done.
Like,
I'm done with her.
Like,
her.
Like, I'm not.
The most, and this is the thing where I'm having an internal struggle with. One of the most diverse and welcoming places I have ever been was
Wendy.
The Wendy Williams Show. It's the most diverse. It's the most welcoming. She goes into the audience.
Yeah, when
and
you say diverse, you're talking about the crew.
The crew. The camera crew.
That crew is bar none.
It's bar none. And then it's not your typical. It's not typical. It's not what you see on these other shows. And what's so great, too, is that she does make it lively and fun. And yet it is nice to check out.
DJ.
It's nice to check out for a little bit and you just have, you know, someone entertain you. But at the same time with entertainment, it comes with, like, I don't want to say a price, but she's had allegations against her before she came on TV from her radio days. She had an assistant who put a claim against her and her husband and sued her, and we've never heard anything about it since.
Nothing.
So we don't know the outcome. It was her assistant, Nicole, claimed that it was an abusive environment, that her husband chokeslammed Wendy Williams in front of her, would make sexual innuendos to Wendy, but in front of Nicole, and then try to get Nicole in some sort of tryst. It was very long time ago. We've never heard anything of it.
Nothing.
But then you see Wendy, who,
which leads me to believe it was settled.
Something was settled. But then it also leads me to believe, you know, as diverse and open and welcoming and fun the show is, now when Wendy sits in her chair and she has an opinion about everybody
and everything,
and you're entitled to it. But she doesn't talk about herself. So,
Even like a little while, like a few months ago, that allegation came out that her husband was having an affair.
Oh, but he cheated on her prior.
But she was came pregnant. On the show. She was like, I knew you guys were reading the papers and stuff. She's like, everything's all good. And she pointed her hand to the camera like, I'm still married.
Yeah, so. She's still married, but she was with him once. He was... Is it true, once a cheater, always a cheater?
Yes, we already discussed this.
Yeah. If a person cheats on you once, they will do it again.
Maybe not.
Is my philosophy when it comes to that. I think everybody cheats.
Right.
But do they cheat on you? No. But if he cheated on you while you were pregnant, with the trouble and trauma that came with it, at such a sensitive time in your life, while you're pregnant and married, that's two huge commitments. You think he's not going to do it again? I don't know.
You know my history with that. Mm-hmm. That's just like, any guy that's going to cheat, number one, cheat. And number two, there's three things. You're going to cheat on your wife. You cheat while she's pregnant.
Ugh.
And you're cheating with somebody who you have not told that you're married. So now you pull them into the cycle of disgustingness. And they don't even know.
Yeah.
So you're lying all the way around. And... You know, there's a lot of people that always say, like, when the side chick, like, the side chick will come out and be like, I didn't know he was married. You know,
when they're talking about celebrity,
but even with celebrity, not everybody knows every celebrity.
There's
you know, just because we know who that celebrity is, does not mean that everybody knows who that person is.
Who knows? I could be, you know, in 5 years, I could be dating an athlete. I wouldn't even know if they're an athlete.
Right.
If I met them. And I wouldn't know anything about them.
Right.
You know, you don't...
You just don't know.
But not only that, it's very easy to believe when you're in a comfortable situation with someone. It's very easy to believe, like, yeah, it says that I'm married to her, but we're not together. This is for TV. This is what we do. It's part of our business.
But see, I wouldn't even date anybody like that. Like, because you're playing games. You're committed more to this image of who you are rather than being committed to who you really are. So which person are you showing me?
Yeah.
You know, and so I... Just, you know, you gotta move on. Shady.
I want answers, Wendy.
It's like, speaking of with the cheating thing, like, and you had mentioned the athletes. I know we talk about this all the time, but even when that thing broke with Khloe Kardashian, none of us were surprised. Number one, because he's an athlete.
Yeah.
Number two, because she's a Kardashian.
Yeah.
You know, so it's like, when it came out, it was like, oh my gosh.
But with her, you're going to keep them how you got them, sweetie.
Exactly. So it's like, you know, you went after a guy that he wasn't married, but he was in a committed relationship with a baby on the way. So, you know, the sympathy is out the door. And
the whole thing,
you know, he was very shady, but she was shady too. And the outcome doesn't surprise me, and it doesn't surprise me that she has decided to stay. Because to me, that signifies somebody that has a low self-esteem.
Yeah, she already showed what she feels her value is.
Right.
By going with someone who has a baby on the way.
Right. So we're not surprised that she's staying. No. You know, it's like one of those things. I wanted to bring up something. You know, I like to share a lot of my personal situations. So tell me, like, okay, there. As you get older. You know, when you're younger, you know, you go through experiences and things like that. And until it happens, you don't recognize. When somebody doesn't bring it up, you don't recognize it. But there's certain things, like there's a gut in your stomach that tells you, you know, whether something feels right.
Intuition.
Well, I was talking to this guy one time. And, you know, we were making plans to go out and stuff. And he was saying things like, you know, he was like apprehensive about... like going out. So we ended up settling on a movie. Like, he didn't want to go out to eat or anything. And I was like, okay, well, you know, it felt weird, but it's like not weird that somebody doesn't want to go to eat. Some people just, you know, want to just get a drink and then see where that goes.
Right.
But a movie to me is like, you're not really communicating. But I was like, okay. He's like, then we can, you know, walk around or whatever after. I was like, all right, fine. So we pull up. Now, this is me. Thinking in my head, like, okay, something right here.
Mm-hmm.
He's acting a little shady, like off-putting.
Okay.
So we get to the theater, we get to the ticket booth, and he steps back.
Okay.
He's like, you got me? I ain't got no money.
Oh, what did you do?
I was like, no, I don't got you.
Did you take your ticket and walk in?
I didn't get the ticket.
Okay.
I'm like, what are you doing? Like, he stepped back. I'm like, what are you doing? And that's when he told me he had no money, you know. He's like, I didn't know to tell you that, you know, I just wanted to just chill, like, maybe go to the park or something. It's fine that you don't got no money, but now you're stepping back and expecting... I guess it's fine. It was fine back then because I was younger. Today, it's not fine.
No.
But, like, it's like one of those things, it's like, I should have known because all my alert and antennas were up and they were like, something ain't right with this guy.
Yeah.
And, you know, I picked him up from his apartment.
Oh, God.
Drove us to the movies, parked the car in the city. Parked the car,
and we just walked to
the theater. You know, when you park in the city, it's not like you're parking in the parking
lot. But, like, I don't understand. You're just going to get to the ticket booth and then just step back?
Step back. Like, you know, like, he's doing...
You were supposed to buy him popcorn, too?
He had no money. Like, I'll take a kid's pack, but really, you got to pay for your ticket?
Oh, my gosh.
So, it's like, some of those things actually happen in life. And you have to, you know, when you see something and it doesn't feel right...
Go with your gut.
You know, everything, you know. It's like one of those things where sometimes you might not feel that you're strong enough to go with your gut. But strength comes in making the best decision for you. You know? And, you know, I wasted my gas. Drove out from Long Island to Harlem. Picked dude up. Took us to the theater. Parked. Walked to the theater. Like, he going through all of the
rigmarole.
Bro, you could have said this before I left Long Island. And then he wanted to ride back. I was like, mm-mm.
You said no.
No, you got... I was like, you got subway fare? He's like, yeah. He probably had one of those, you know, Metro card, you know, monthly.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you live in the city.
The pass, yeah. Wow.
He's like, all right, I'll call. He called me. I didn't answer.
And that was
back then, they didn't call it ghosting. Now it's ghosting.
Now there's a word
That's what
for
the
it.
Kids are calling it. So it's like...
Back then, it was just ignore. Fade out.
Then I had... Like, I've had some of the worst... I've dated and gone on some of the worst dates from hell. One of the other ones, I was talking to this guy. We were talking for like a week or two. But he was like very, very much into me. He was like, you know, constantly like, you know, you're so beautiful, you're so pretty. And I never believe anybody that tells me that.
Yeah,
I know that sounds
crazy. For
some reason,
I know. You are crazy.
But it's like, you're going to tell me, you're going to keep telling me that off the bat. Like, it just feels very awkward. For me, you know, it's like some girls like to be told they're beautiful left and right. I just don't. I want you to tell me, you know, you're so smart and intelligent.
Yeah.
You know, I value that more. And then you can go into, you know, you have really nice lips.
Yeah. Yeah, like
But lips. Anyway, so I'm
What that mouth do, though?
Marissa.
I'm sorry.
Oh, my gosh. I wasn't talking all that. Talking about slobbing a knob. That's disgusting.
Oh, I didn't say that.
You might as well have.
Ew.
Anyway, so... talking to this guy. Child, I came home from work, right?
Oh, gosh.
Walk in my cousin's room. Dude is sitting up in the bed with her. So he's talking to both of us. He didn't know that we was cousins.
Yeah, I remember this. And he looked at you like,
What are you doing here? I was like, that's my cousin, motherfucker.
That is amazing.
So it's like, you kind of, like, there's always these warning signals.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's whether you want to act on it, ignore it, whatever the case may be. But I knew, like, there was something wrong with this guy. But I didn't know, like, that.
Like that,
you don't think, like, okay.
Well, mofo's got a type.
Yeah. Well, no, me and my cousin are nothing alike.
The same.
So it's not a type. The only thing that me and her have in common is that we're both black and we like music.
Yeah.
But we don't have, we're not,
no, you're not,
nothing
you're not
alike.
Like, no.
You know.
Oh, that's so funny.
Yeah, so.
I want you to write... like the adventures of dating.
I've been writing this book for like 5 years.
But it's
longer
it's
than that.
But the thing is, you have such a beautiful collection of stories that like the world needs to hear this.
There's a lot of them.
Yeah.
I've been on way too many dates. Ridiculous. Because I can't commit to a mofo. But look,
why?
Look at the dudes that I end up like. Really, do I want to commit to the guy that's like laying up in the bed with my cousin?
No.
Not that they were doing it; they were laying up there watching TV.
No, but he was talking to you and talking to her. He was trying to see where something went.
Right. And it's like, bro.
No.
We're cousins. Like.
I used to hate back when I was dating or talking or like getting to know people in that sense. When they'd always be like, "But you're not like what I'm looking for. You're like wifey material, and I'm not ready for that." And you know, at the moment, I'm like. I wouldn't husband you up either, by the way, but I appreciated that.
Right.
But then at the same, though, you're such a good girl. okay, but you're not husband material.
Right. It's always like...
Or when somebody's like, I would have married you. I wouldn't have married you. Ew.
Exactly. Like, it's like this expectation that, like, all girls want to be married and...
No,
wanna,
they don't.
You know, I mean, I would like to be married, okay?
Mm-hmm.
But I would like to be married to somebody that I, number one, like.
Yeah, that's important.
Like, I have to like them.
That is important.
You know? Yeah. But I'm glad I've been through the process of engagement. At least I know what it feels like to rock a ring on my finger.
A ring you don't quite like.
But, you know, if you don't like a mofo, you got to move on.
Yeah.
You know, if you don't get along, you can't just get married just for the sake of getting married. But I know a lot, I don't know a lot of people, but I'm sure there are a lot of women out there that just get married because it's what, you know, society tells them that they have to do.
That's
whether they married somebody that's shady or not.
That's one of the things that I'm trying to instill into my children, my daughter, as well as my boys, where I feel like, you know, a lot of society helps you or shapes a certain frame of thinking where progression in life means dating, married, buying a house, doing all this. And that's not for everybody. Everybody doesn't want that, and that's okay. If that's what you want, then that's your plan, and that's okay. But it doesn't mean you're not progressing in life.
That's true.
It irks me when I see it, but it irks me because that's how I felt at the time. Like my brother and my cousins, a collection of cousins that I have, were relatively the same age and we're pretty close. They were all married. And I was like, I'm a spinster. I'm going to die alone.
At 24, 25.
Yeah, I got married at 25. Like, really? That's so young. Like, I think about it now and I'm like, what a stupid way to think.
I mean, Prince Harry is 33, Meghan Markle's 36. And people are like, oh my gosh, you waited so long. But it's like,
it's not.
Some people think that and other people like, 33 is like the perfect age.
Age, yeah.
You know, I think your 30s are a good age. You know?
Yeah.
I feel like in your 30s, you know, a lot of growth can be met within yourself. Not necessarily, you may not have the career you want or anything like that, but you've seen a lot. And hopefully,
yeah.
you finished school and you've gone to some places. And
You can do more selfish.
Yeah.
And which is what everyone should do. I think that the self-care that we don't give each other and ourselves is so paramount. We need to instill that. The self-care that you have before you can help care for someone else or just be in a partnership, really.
The problem with that, though, is on the flip side of it is that biologically speaking,
mm-hmm.
women can't wait.
They can't. You're right.
You know, so it's like our bodies genetically, biologically, have been set up to marry in our 20s.
Yeah, and procreate in our 20s.
Right. Yeah. Or younger, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And so it's like one of those, you wait until your 30s, it's like, oh, like I was telling you, you know, last episode, a few episodes ago, when I was like 32, my dad was like, I want a grandchild. And it's like, I'm not ready.
Yeah.
You know, but, you know, the thing about it is, as a woman, I might not be mentally ready, but my body was ready.
Yeah.
So you have to find the go-between. You have to figure out what's best for you, you know, physically, emotionally, mentally, and
thank God for in vitro.
Yeah. For some. It doesn't work for everybody. It didn't work for me, so you can't say that either.
Yeah.
So fix your words.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Well, for me, thank God for in vitro.
Yeah,
But I also think, too, like, I didn't have kids later on in life. I just knew that something was wrong. Like, because we didn't prevent anything. I just knew something was not happening. But as far as, like, how we progressed, the self-care.
It did happen later in life, though, in your 30s.
Yeah.
So it was later
in... No, I mean later in life. Like, I wasn't going through the in vitro process at 40, 45,
oh, right,
50.
Right.
And now, what is it? Now they're pushing to 60s now, somewhere?
Yeah, that ain't happening. Like, Janet had hers at 50.
Like, oh, no, girl, I'm tired thinking about it. I'm tired now.
But I guess if you got the money to take care of, to, you know, hire the people that are going to...
Your team. Your tribe. Yeah, your tribe.
You know?
But wait, I don't want to deviate too much. I want to go back to the shady mofos. Have you ever... Because I have yet to encounter someone. Even, you know, like when the family secrets, or like you're at a funeral or at the gathering and you find out something about family and you're
I love it.
Not surprised. Or like, you know, the worst is like when somebody comes into a windfall or a downfall. Like if there's a death in the family and it rocks the family, or you come into a windfall, people's true colors really, really show.
Yeah.
And it's very hard to hide who you naturally are. So when things like that come about, you're like, you know... again, I'm not surprised. Right. I was surprised by something recently.
What's that?
I don't want to say just in case they're listening, but I was definitely really surprised by a family member and a little bit hurt. Not for me, but for who they were dealing with.
Can you paraphrase the situation or is it too much?
I would say we all have our own responsibilities within our network. And when you first say you will take on your responsibility and then turn around and say, no, I don't want that, I think that's a really crappy thing to do to someone else.
Yeah, I agree. But, I agree.
I was hurt.
But were you surprised that it
I was hurt. No, but I wasn't surprised. No. Because, but, like, when I thought about it for a second, I'm like, oh, no, I'm not surprised.
Yeah, it surprised me.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's one thing when you see it in the public eye. Mm-hmm. It's another thing when you recognize it in your own family.
Yeah.
It's like, damn.
And what's crazy is that I've been trying to do the self-reflection, you know, because I know I've been that to someone else. Because I'm still learning how to say no. And, you know, the times I've said yes begrudgingly, I know I've disappointed someone. So I can't think of the situation.
Do you think saying yes is a disappointment to others?
When you don't want to.
Oh, because they can feel it.
Not only that they can feel it, but you don't do it. Or you find every excuse to, like, oh, right. I'm sorry, I'm late.
Yeah, I've been on the receiving end of that.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway.
Should have kept my mouth shut.
Weird silence right now. Pregnant pause.
Awkward. But it's like, you have got to learn to say no. Wait, I want to talk about something.
Okay.
You
keep saying that. Just talk about it. Oh. Bring it up. Put your phone away.
I'm looking at my note.
Okay. Well, look at you. I'm blowing up your spot. No, yes, I am.
No, I want to talk about how in these last few days. So this week was La Boda Royal. The royal wedding.
So are we gonna introduce this new topic?
Yes. Okay.
So
drum roll.
To the end of each episode, we're going to have every week from now on. It's going to be called "Yep, that's trending."
Yep.
So what's trending this week, Marcia?
The royal wedding, Boda Royal. So I've been noticing how they talk about Meghan Markle, the way she's black, she doesn't follow protocol. Her mama was sitting all alone up in the church with nobody else around. Poor sad Meghan Markle's
mom.
There
was a couple sitting next to her.
Yeah.
But she wasn't with them. But she wasn't by herself.
Yeah. But, I mean, and then the speculation why her family wasn't there and what's going on with her family and all that stuff. Like, the way... One side of her family. Yeah. Everyone was concerned about her black side. Her white side, for some reason, was acting crazy. But I digress.
Yeah.
But I want to talk about, so Katy Perry, you brought this up. Katy Perry, what did she say?
She said that Meghan's dress didn't fit her well. She needed another fitting, and that Kate had a better dress, and Kate wins.
First of all.
And my response is, number one, and you've corrected me, that Kate is going to be queen. It's a different stature. Her dress has to be a certain way. It has to be, like, you notice how they are in public is mm-hmm. very different. Because he's going to be king one day.
He is third in line to the throne.
Right. I mean...
But she will never be queen. But here's the thing, though. But like you said, you said this, and I'm stealing your words yet again, what'd you say? Take several seats, because if you're Anna Wintour, give me fashion advice. Give me a critique, but when you're not...
When you're like, Katy Perry, it's like...
Shut up. I thought the dress was beautiful. I thought it fit her well. Maybe she didn't want a tight-ass dress.
Exactly. I thought her dress was perfectly fine. I think she looked beautiful.
I thought... Yeah.
That veil,
that train...
The two boys with no teeth.
Shut your face. Oh, that killed me.
Right? The whole thing was... And then did you see the picture of them, the family portrait, or the wedding portrait?
Which one? With all the kids?
With all the kids and the royal family?
Yes.
And I'm like, I have never seen a more diverse...
I loved it.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, her one of her best friend's daughters, and then, you know, she's biracial, her black mother. Like, it's just...
Gorgeousness. I loved it.
And I'm like, and this is not Bobo down the street. This is the royal family.
The royal family, yeah.
Like, what in the world is... Like, this is the world that we live in today.
I like
No matter what anybody wants to pretend, like, we live in this weird society, we live in this society.
Yeah.
What are you going to say?
No, but do you see how, like, there was a meme going around where the Queen Mum, the Grand Majesty, she was looking, it looked like she had a screw face on, and they were like, first they take off 13 colonies, then they take your grandson. Oh my God, that killed me. That was amazing. But it's like, you know, she could have been coughing or clearing her throat or something.
Yeah, they catch those awkward moments. But you can't deny, like, when the preacher was preaching, or the reverend, the faces, they were all, like, doing side eyes and stuff.
Because they're not used to that.
Right. Yeah. But who doesn't do that in church?
Everybody does that in church.
If that was a real church, there would be a lot more going on. Yeah. People would cry, babies. There'd be all kinds of stuff going on.
I know. But I loved it, though. I loved everything about it. I loved having them candles never flickered when homeboy, like, those candles was doing the most when he was doing the most.
I've never seen a smile like that. Like, I look at the photos of him. I've never seen him smile like that, ever.
And what car did they drive off in?
The Jaguar.
Girl!
$300,000 car. $1 million car. Her dress was $300,000.
I need to get me one of those cars.
Oh, I thought you said one of those princes.
Oh, did you see the... Do you see how, like, they're... First of all, gay Twitter, thank you. Gay Instagram, thank you. They compiled a list within 33 minutes of him saying, I will, of the next royal princesses that we need to be, you know, looking our eyes to. So, Denmark has a prince that is delicious, and he's in his 30s. Oh, he's looking fine.
I have to look at this list.
You need to look at this list.
But see, it's like, where are they be at, though? Like, I think about the African prince who met the girl in the club.
Yes!
Now she, like, you know what I'm saying?
Yes! Like, really?
What in Zamunda is going on here?
Wakanda forever!
They were up in Jamaica, Queens. No, okay. No, they were in D.C. Ugh. It's like...
Oh, my gosh. I met my prince in Dave and Buster's.
Aww.
Yeah, I love that place.
Yeah. And you still go there?
I still go there all the time. Yeah. I love it.
Nice. Yeah. I'm not trying to meet no dude in Dave and Buster's, because that means he plays games. I don't need nobody to play games with me. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, my God.
But, yeah, the wedding was like, I watched it. I was away, but I actually TiVo'd it and watched it when I got back. And I was like, for real, I shed a few tears. Like, I'm just watching. Yeah, I did. Because I'm like, this is just amazing. I've never seen nothing like this before.
And such a high profile of diversity, welcoming, openness.
It's like, she for real, is what you envision, like, anything can happen.
Oh, like,
because she does not come from, she's not cultured.
What about Grace Kelly?
Same thing, but I don't know what Grace Kelly's parents, but it, like, oh, I don't know that much about her. I just know that Megan came from Crenshaw.
Yeah, from Crenshaw, yeah.
Interracial relationship.
But I feel like, I keep interrupting you today.
No,
I apologize.
Go ahead.
My apologies. But I feel like that is what America is, the land of multiple opportunity. And I know we're very divisive at the moment, and we have created an environment where it's okay to say things that are hateful. If you say things to educate yourself and to ask questions, that is one thing. But when you're divisive, that's a whole other thing, which is going to transition me into something else. But before I get there, I just want to talk about how that is the picture of, this is truly the land of multiple opportunity. And I feel like...
Well, that is over there.
That is. No, this Meghan Markle, the homegirl from Crenshaw becoming a royal?
Prince Harry.
That is on another level of opportunity.
You know how her mother's standing there like, wanted you to graduate college.
What happened when she was like, they were trying to say, like, trying to shade her, like, when she met Harry, she was dating some chef. I would have been like, bye with you and your fucking Ginzu knives, all right?
Like,
peace.
Don't be, for
don't
real,
hate on
it's
nothing.
Harry. You Somebody know. Says, I look, you want to go out on a date with this guy?
Yup.
Y'all, it's not like you was engaged and ready. You
no.
Wasn't he invited to the wedding, too? Like, that's the other thing. They invited all their exes.
But apparently that's something that
that's
they do.
That's weird.
That is so hot, though.
That's weird.
No, I love it. You know,
so you're telling me at your wedding you would have had your exes. Now, think about your exes.
My exes? They would never
How
know.
Would you feel about your current beau's exes being there?
I would have loved it.
So you got to say vice versa.
Mine wouldn't have showed. They hate me.
No, I'm saying you're in the same position where they just show. Like, it's...
They were invited.
Your exes were invited to your
wedding. No, at the Royals. The Royals invite their exes to their wedding.
I know.
Mine would not show up because they're all
I'm not talking about whether they show up or not. I'm talking about whether they... How would you feel about them being there?
I don't know.
Like...
I'd be fine.
Was Harry thinking about Cressida and Chelsea? Well, he didn't look like he was thinking about anybody but Megan.
No, he wasn't. Yeah.
And they looked like... They was like, damn, I missed my shot.
No.
But it's like, to me, like those two girls, the two exes, they have a similar look. Yeah. About them. So I'm like...
Which is probably why it didn't work.
And I'm just wondering if he was attracted to Megan's brain. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, she's very worldly and... Like, they met in, like, Botswana through a charity
And
work.
That's the thing. Like, when you take... My stepdad is English, and I've been to England a lot. But when you take an American mind, American female mind that is willing to travel and be out there and be open... And you take that to someone who's English, a little bit more reserved, just a different culture. It's nice. It's one of those like, oh my god, you're a little too like you wild with your mouth.
There was a British guy that I really had a big crush on, but I was too scared. And it's like one of those things where my fear wasn't about him; it was about everyone else. And that's a lesson, too. It's like, you got to go with your heart. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
I'm just not going to bring up his name. But
yeah, but which I always say that would have been the best.
Yeah, but you know, when you make decisions based on the feelings of others,
then you
end up by yourself.
You lose. You always lose. When you make decisions based on others, you lose.
Yeah.
I want to end off on a bit of a salty note.
Okay.
So this week, there was a female... who is talking about she took her college senior photos on campus holding a rifle. And she had her cap decorated with Trump and Trump Organization verbiage.
Mm-hmm.
Now, she's saying, this happens to be a Caucasian female.
No.
She's saying, and she was booed while she was on stage getting her diploma. Now, she is saying that she feels like she is the victim of racism. Because what the verbiage is saying about what she did, she showed up on a college campus to take photos with a rifle. That had that been somebody of color, that person would not have walked off of that college campus. That is white privilege to go on there and take college photos with a rifle and walk away alive. So she's saying that she's the victim of racism because she... did what she did because of her Second Amendment rights and not because of her white privilege.
Well, the thing about white privilege is that usually the white person doesn't realize they're privileged.
Mm-hmm.
White privilege is something you get called when someone recognizes it in you.
Right.
And so for her to be like, I didn't do it because of my white privilege, it's like, okay, are you saying that you recognize that you do have white privilege, but this wasn't an instance where you was using it?
She is saying that it had nothing to do with white privilege, that people are hating on her because she is a proponent of the Trump Organization and her Second Amendment right to bear arms.
I think people are hating on her for that. I do believe that hating on her
because she's a Trump supporter. Yeah.
But I also think people are hating on her for the hypocrisy that has nothing to do with her. It's about society.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's true. If it was somebody of color doing the exact same thing, they might have got arrested.
Well,
they wouldn't have been allowed to go on the stage.
Am I not educated enough? Aren't college campuses gun safe, gun free zones?
It depends on... I don't think it's, like, a standard.
It's a standard... Oh, okay.
And especially for a state that's, like, you have the... What is it called? Carry?
Concealed carry.
Whatever it is.
Well, but it's
I
not...
I can't speak on every... I don't know the state laws.
Well, as far as gun control goes, I'm not going to get into that argument. I will say my opinion. My opinion is we need smarter gun laws.
Right.
Across the board, I don't care where you sit, there needs to be smarter gun laws. I can give you an argument on both sides where that needs to happen. But
especially in light of what just happened at the school in Texas, God bless them.
Well, and that's what's so important about. Oh my gosh! So I have been teacher assisting in a school, And I've been doing recess and lunch for K through fifth grade. And you begin to notice when a child is not really welcomed by their peer group. There's one thing that just happened last week. There's a kid with a severe peanut allergy, and three girls brought in a bag full of peanut shells and chased him with it at a playground. You know, he could have died. They were very young. I don't know if they just didn't understand.
They didn't understand.
But did they?
They didn't understand, but they didn't care.
Oh, they did understand, but they didn't care.
No, they didn't understand that the... They didn't understand that that he could die.
He could die.
But they didn't care to understand it either. It's like a group thing.
Well, see that... Oh, the mob mentality, you mean?
But that's when somebody that recognizes it needs to step in and educate them. Mm-hmm. Don't just be like, stop, that's not nice.
Well, see, that's the thing. So, I happened to be there while they were chasing, and it was his aide. He has a one-to-one aide, and she showed them, like, you know he has an EpiPen. They're like, yeah, but you're here. And I feel like, no, they did know what could happen. They just didn't care.
But when I say they don't know, I think it's like, death seems so like...
Oh, like not to a child. Like, yeah.
Yeah, they don't really get it.
Yeah.
You know, they have to... It's even if they bury, you know, children bury grandparents and stuff like that, and they don't see them. But I don't think they understand, like, death.
Death, yeah. Like, true death. And then I think about, like, now what if you're that child's parent? You're the peanut allergy child parent, and you find out about this incident.
I'm going to raise hell.
Right? Yeah. Like, what do you do? Like,
I might even call the parent.
Yeah. All of the children that brought it in? Yeah.
I don't know. It's, you know, it's a lot to think about. There's a lot going on out there, and you're talking about young kids, and that's where it starts.
Yeah.
And then they get to high school, and now it's like, you know.
I've spoken to a lot of police officers that feel like, you know, when you get there, I've heard...
Finish your thought.
I've heard a lot of police officers say something to the effect of, you know, half of these things could be avoided if you just gave a fourth grader two extra hugs. And while that sounds so like, really, you're going to give two extra hugs and it's somebody's not going to come in with an AK-47 in high school, but no, yeah, you're right. You think about this incident in Texas. You had a child, a kid, on camera saying how not only did his peer groups, but other coaches, apparently this was a person that was an excellent athlete, and you had coaches making fun of him in front of other kids. Really?
It's like one of those things where you can start delving into other things, because people are bringing up mental illness, and you know, you know how I feel. Like, there's a lot of people that are mentally ill and don't go and shoot up a school.
Right.
So painting that brush on everybody that shoots up a school is not right.
Yeah.
The other thing, too, is that you can't blame death a whole bunch of people that, it's not like he went and killed his coaches.
Right.
He killed innocent people. You know what I mean? And so I feel like people are always trying to make excuses for these high school shooters and mass murderers. They're terrorists. Treat them like terrorists.
Yeah.
You weren't making excuses for the guy with his brother. His brother ended up dying with the Boston bombers. He was a teenager.
You don't make
excuses for him. You don't make excuses for the man, the DC rifle, the DC snipers.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, that was a child.
Right.
Yeah.
There's only certain people you make excuses for, and it's code. But we're not going to get into that today.
Today.
We'll wait till February, and it's Black History Month. We can get into that again.
Or September.
But that ain't got... It's not black people.
Spanish people.
Yeah, but we're not talking about Spanish people right now.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you for listening, y'all.
Thank you.
I appreciate you.
Check us out on... What, Marissa?
Yep, yeah, yes.
18.
18, sorry.
Yep, yeah, yes. She always be up in it, right? Yep, yeah, yes, 18 on Instagram and yep, yeah, yes on Twitter.
Thank you.
There's no two.
Something's got a two in it.
Yeah. That would be our email.
Oh,
yep, yeah, yes, two at
gmail.com.
And email us if you want.
Well, do us a favor and like us. And enjoy every day.
Retweet, repost, reshare.
Did nobody get that?
Download.
Do?
What's do?
Do. Morning do.
Oh, well, I thought that you were
shout
saying,
out to the do.
Everybody don't know do like that.
Oh, and hola gato.
Yeah, and Frank. Anyway. Bye, y'all. Talk to you next week. Adios.